we have discussed? 17th, have we discussed? How we discuss 17th question? Okay, up to 16th we have discussed. Okay, start with 17th. We will complete this exercise. If time permits, we will start the method of cross multiplication. Or else tomorrow we will start the method of cross multiplication. Okay, 17th question, solve it by equating the quotient. So first simplify the equation. Everyone start doing the 17th question. And find the equation in simplified form. X minus 5 plus 10 y minus 2 plus 54 equal to 0. This is our first equation. Second equation, 7, 2x minus 1 plus 9, 3y minus 1 equal to 25. Okay, so take the first equation and simplify the first equation. Okay, so 17th question we are starting of 6B exercise. Okay, simplify these equations and find the equations. Everyone start doing. So first take the first equation, open the bracket. So if I open the bracket, it will be 11x minus 55 plus 10y minus 20 plus 54 equal to 0. Simplify it. And how much are you getting?
11x
plus 10y equals 21. 11x plus 10y equal to 21. 55 equal to 21. Okay. This is our first equation. Okay. This is clear. Okay. Now, second one. Everyone solve the second equation. Simplify the second equation. Open the bracket and solve it. So I'll use the blue pen now, okay? 7 to ja 14x minus 7 plus 9 to ja 27y minus 9 equal to 25. Simplify it and find the equation. Equal to 9, 7, 16, 41.
So 14x plus 27y equals to 41.
14x plus 27y equal to 41.
14x plus 27y equal to 41. This is our second equation. So you have got the two equations in simplified form. Now we have to equate the quotient. So before that, how we are going to equate? First equation, okay, so these are the two equations we can write. 11x plus 10y equal to 21. Second equation is 14x plus 27y equal to 41. Okay, we cannot simplify. Okay, more. Okay, these are the most simplified form of the equation. Okay, now whose quotient should we make same? X or y? Here, if we make the quotient of y same, that will be more easier. 10 is there. So simply we have to multiply with 10. And here, 27. So it's better to equate the y quotients. Okay. Multiply this one, 27, 27. So 297 it will come, I think. So first equation you are multiplying with. Second equation we are multiplying with 10. Okay, so multiplying the first equation with 27 and multiplying the second equation with 10. So it will be how much? 297x plus 270y equal to how much? Calculate and tell.
560.
5, 6, 7 it will be. Okay, this will be a false. Okay, multiply with 10. 140x plus 270y equal to 410. Okay, so do we have to add or subtract? These, we have made the quotient same. Numerically, we have made the quotient. So we'll subtract, and so subtract will be minus, minus, minus. This is clear. Okay. Subtract them. How much you'll get? 157x. Okay. And how much here? This minus this, this minus this. Zero. And how much here?
157.
Okay. So x is how much? Very small value we got.
One.
X equal to one. X equal to one. Now, which equation is more easier to calculate the value of y? First one, put x equal to 1 there and calculate the value of y. Y as well, how much you are getting?
1.
So, at last, you have to write x equal to 1 and y equal to 1. Okay, then underline, two underlines you put. Have you understood? Anyone have doubt? Anyone who haven't got the answer? Okay, try 18th. Solve 18th, everyone. Everyone have done 17th. Okay, 18th and 19th today we'll solve, and tomorrow we'll start the new exercise. Okay, solve it. Solve 18th. These equations are very important. Okay, as well, I think you have used these two equations, simultaneous equation in solving in physics as well. In physics as well, there was one question in which initial velocity you have to calculate as well as the acceleration, and the distance covered in 1 second is this much, 3 meters, and distance traveled in 2 seconds is eight meters. In that as well, you have used two simultaneous equations, if you remember, for second C chapter, motion in one dimension. Do you remember that one? One question is there. In that, you are going to use simultaneous equations only. This, you are going to apply these simultaneous equations there. Okay, try to find that question today. Okay, second C. Is second C completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then find that question where you are going to use the simultaneous equations. Okay. There is one question in which initial velocity as well you have to calculate as well as acceleration, and it is being provided distance covered is 3 meters in 1 second and 8 meters in 3 seconds, I think. Okay. Okay, do the 18th question now. So first we will try to remove the denominators. Minus 2x minus y divided by 4 equal to 3y minus 5. Okay, second equation I will write later. Okay, simplify this equation, everyone. So cross multiply here, and LCM, okay, LCM we are taking, not cross multiplying. LCM is 20. 4 7 28 plus 4x. Okay, here now the trick is there. What is going to come here? Minus how much? 10x. Okay, here minus or plus?
Plus.
It will be plus. Okay, if you are not able to get it, whether it's plus or minus, play safe. Okay, how to play safe? Put here 5. Okay, and 2x minus y in bracket. Okay. This you understood? 5 minus sign is here, 5, and this whole thing in bracket you put equal to 3y minus 5. Okay, 28 plus 4x minus 10x plus 5y. Okay, divided by 20 equal to 3y minus 5. Okay, Now pay attention here. Y equal to plus. See here, this minus is for the whole. This minus sign is for the whole. Now this negative sign we are distributing. This minus sign is for the whole, minus 5. So this negative sign is for the whole. Now we have distributed this minus sign. Minus 10x minus minus, it will get plus. Okay, always remember this one. Most of the students make mistake here. Minus, they forget to multiply these negatives. Okay, understood this one? Okay, solve it now. 20 you take on this side and solve it and find the equation what you have got.
6x plus 55y is equal to 128.
Okay, so here you will get 60y minus 5, you will get 55y. Okay, 6x minus 6x, you take on this side, it will be 6x. And here it will be minus 100, take on that side, it will be 128. Okay, this equation you have got. This is our first equation. Okay, this is our first equation. Okay, now solve the second equation similarly. So this, okay, second equation, what will be the LCM? Is it 12 or 6?
Sir, 6.
6, okay. So take the LCM 6 and solve. Here, since plus sign is going to be distributed, there will be no issue. Second equation.
34x plus 15y equals 132.
Okay, 34x plus 15y, you will be getting that equation. 5y minus 7 divided by 2 plus 4x minus 3 divided by 6 equal to 18 minus 5x. Take the LCM, multiply with this 3. So 15y minus 21 plus 4x minus 3 divided by 6. 6 will come this side, 6 into 18 minus 5x. And solve this one. So you are getting 34x plus 15y equal to how much? 132. Okay, this is our second equation. Okay, we write these equations. 6x plus 55y equal to 128. Second equation is 34x plus, again, whose quotient it is, are, is more easier to make numerically equal?
Y.
Y. So go with Y. So with what we should multiply?
The first one with 3 and second with 11.
With 11. Okay. Multiply them. First one we are going to multiply with 3 and second one with 11. You can see 55 is 5 into 11. Okay. 15 is 5 into 3. So this equation has to be multiplied with 3 and this equation has to be multiplied with 11 to make them equal. Okay. Okay, multiply them. Eighteen x plus 384. You'll be getting this 384. Okay, multiply the next one.
Yes.
Sir, 374x
plus 165 y is equals to 1452.
1452 you are getting. Okay.
Yes.
132 11. 1452. Okay. Now we have to add or subtract.
Subtract.
We have to subtract. We have to cancel these terms. Minus, minus, minus. Okay. 18x minus 374. 18x minus 374. How much you get? 356. 356. Okay. And negative sign x plus 0 equal to how much? 1452 minus 384.
Minus 1068.
Minus 384.
Minus
1068.
Minus minus will get cancelled. 1068. Okay, calculate the value of x.
3.
3 you are getting, okay. Okay, y value you can calculate. Calculate the value of y.
2.
2 you will get. Okay, any of these equations we can put. X equal to 3 will put and we calculate the value of y. Y equal to 2. Okay, solve it fast. Those who have solved start doing 19th question.
Sir, can you tell that how this 3 and 11 came?
Okay, how this 3 and 11 came? Okay. So why you waited this time? This much time you have waited. You must have asked earlier. So that's here. The moment the doubt arises, ask immediately, okay? Whatever kind of doubt, it doesn't matter. Just ask, okay? So see here, what we are going to equate. Either x coefficient, we can make them equal. How to make them equal? Okay? Or we can make the coefficient of y equal, numerically equal. Okay? So for time being, we are making y and then we'll see for x as well, okay? We have to make them equal. So here we are having 55y and here we are having 15y. Okay, how we can make them equal? Okay, one simple method is we multiply it with 15 and multiply it with 55. But this will be a large number, yes or no? This will make it a large number. Okay, so see here, smallest we have to find. Smallest number we must find to multiply it and the smallest number to multiply it so that they becomes equal. That we are going to find. Okay. So forget about y. Only this you have to make. So 55 can be written as how? These are the prime factors. 5 and 11 in terms of prime factors. Okay. 15. 5 into 3. This is clear. So see here, 5 is already there. Okay. Now, to make them equal, what we'll do? First, if we multiply with 3. 3. Okay. And this number, if you multiply it with 11. See here, they are same or not. Now, we have made the same. So, first equation, we are multiplying with 3. So, first equation, we are going to multiply with 3. And second equation, we are going to multiply with 11. And that's how we are going to make them equal. Understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Similarly, if we are making x terms same, quotient of x, they are 6 and 34. So 6 will be written as 2 into 3. And this, how this is going to be written? 2 into 17. Okay. Now see what is already there. 2 and 2. So first equation, we will multiply with 17. And the second equation we multiply with 3. Okay. So first equation is to be multiplied with 17. Second equation is to be multiplied with 3. So that both the coefficient, they will become same. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, do the next one. 19th. Do the 19th question. And with that question, we'll stop. Okay. So sooner you do, sooner you can leave the class. But don't make mistake.
Sir, completed.
Completed, okay. So complete this question. Okay, it's 12:52 only. Don't leave the class. Don't leave. It's 52 only. Okay. 19th question. 4x plus x minus y divided by 8 equal to 17. Second is 2y plus x minus 5y plus 2 divided by 3 equal to 2. Okay. So either you can take the LCM or you can take 4 this side and whole multiply with 8 this side. Any way you can do, okay? It's up to you. Okay. So I'm taking LCM. It will be 8. So 8 4 is 32x plus x minus y equal to 17. Okay. As well, 8 we can remove and it will be multiplied here. Solve this one and tell what you're getting.
So 33x minus
x minus y is 136.
136. Okay, 136. This is our first equation. Okay, solve second equation. You have to pay. Okay, second equation. Pay attention because minus sign is outside the whole fraction. Second equation. 2y plus x minus 5y plus 2 divided by 3. This is equal to 2. Okay. Solve it. So LCM is 3. 3 to ja 6y plus 3x. Okay. What about this sign? Minus 5y. Whether it will be plus 2 or minus 2.
Minus 2.
See, at this minus sign, it is for the whole. So we are taking it inside minus 2 equal to 2. And 3 we can remove, it will be 6. Okay. So how much? 3x minus y equal to 8. Are you getting this equation?
3x plus y.
1 minute, plus yes, plus y, plus y, plus y. 6y is there, plus y equal to 8, okay? 6y minus 5y, that is y. 3x plus y equal to 8. So the equations are 33x minus y equal to 136. 3x plus y equal to 8, okay? Now, whose quotient should we take? Y terms we should take? See, the quotients are numerically equal, that is without sign, the quotients are same. Okay, now we have to add or subtract.
Add.
Them. So we are getting 36x plus 0 equal to how much?
144.
Okay, x equal to 144 here by 36. Calculate it.
Four.
Okay, calculate y. Put in this equation, it will be more easy. So put in
minus 4.
X equal to 4 and 3x plus y equal to 8. So 3 into 4 plus y equal to 8. Y equal to 12 minus 8, that is 8 minus 12. That is minus 4. It equal to minus 4. Have you got the answer?
Yes, sir.
Have you all got the answer?
Yes, sir.
So till now, we have discussed two methods of multiplication, or two methods of solving the simultaneous equation. Okay. The first method, what we did, for example, these two equations are given. Okay. If these two equations are given and you have to solve using the first method, that is elimination of one of the variables by substitution. So what we'll do, we'll calculate the y value. We can tell the y in terms of x and we'll put here. Okay. Now our equation will be reduced to one variable only, x. And we can calculate the value of x. And then putting the value of x in any of the equations, we can calculate the value of y. This was the first method. Okay. Elimination of a variable in terms of other variable. That was method of elimination. Okay. Second method, by equating the coefficients, we are eliminating one variable. Yes or no? By equating the coefficients, we have eliminated which variable? Y variable. And we have got the equation back in one variable and we have solved it. Okay. To solve one variable, we require only one equation. To solve two variables, we require two variables. And then any of these methods, three methods are given, any of these methods we are used. These two methods are very clear to all. Yes. Okay. So third method will start tomorrow. Okay. That is method of cross multiplication.
It is asked.
See here, if in question, if it is asked, then you have to use the same method. Okay. Which have been asked. Okay. You have to follow, you have to solve using that method. Okay. If it is not mentioned in question, if it is not mentioned in question, then you are free to use any of these, any one of these three methods. Okay. If it is not asked, you are free to use any of the method which suits you or which is easier as per the question. So you can see the question and can analyze which method is more easier to use. Okay. If it is mentioned in question, then you have to go with that method. If it is not mentioned, then it's up to you. It's your choice. Or if you feel which method is more easier to solve, you can go with that. Okay. Seeing the question, you can figure that out. Okay. Any more doubts you have? Okay, so we stop the class today 2 minutes early, and tomorrow we will start the next chapter. Okay, next exercise, method of cross multiplication. Okay, it is very interesting as well. Method of cross multiplication is very, very interesting. 6D, 6A, 6D. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Okay, then we end the class here. Anything you want to ask, you can ask. Any trouble you have been facing or anything you want to ask? Okay, one more thing. Okay.
No, sir, remind
every teacher that Daksh, he's not having the password. Okay. So please do admit him. Okay. For time being, he's not having the password. I've forwarded. As soon as the admin forwards me the password, I will give him. So till then, if you see him in lobby, please tell the teacher, subject teachers, to admit him, Daksh. Okay. Okay, then thank you all. We end the class here.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.